In this video, I'll cover how to manage permissions for Microsoft Defender XDR and Microsoft Sentinel in the new unified security operations experience. First, note that all permissions are the same for Microsoft Sentinel and Microsoft Defender XDR. For Microsoft Sentinel, everything is still configured and managed using the Azure Role-Based Access Control, or RBAC model. For Microsoft Defender XDR, you can either use Global Entra ID roles or what I'll be showing today, Unified RBAC permissions. To start, I'll show you how to configure Unified RBAC permissions. To create Unified RBAC permissions, you must have either Global Administrator or Security Administrator permission. Once you have Global or Security Administrator permissions, you can create Unified RBAC roles that can then manage other permissions. To manage permissions, go into the Unified SecOps experience at security.microsoft.com and under System, select Permissions. From here, you'll select Roles under Microsoft Defender XDR. Now, you can see current roles and create new ones. Before you even start creating roles, you need to make sure that all workloads are enabled. Select Workload Settings, and make sure that you select the workloads for which you want to enable Unified RBAC roles. Next, go to Permissions and Roles. If you already have workload-specific RBAC roles, for example, Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, you can import the roles by selecting Import Roles, then selecting Endpoint and Vulnerability Management. Next, you'll see the roles that are currently available. You can select one or both to import. Select Next, and then select Submit. When you submit, you'll get those roles inside Unified RBAC and see that they have been imported. You can also create custom roles. To create a custom role, I add the role name. For this example, it's SOC Tier 1. I can add a description, select Next, and then choose the permissions I want. Permissions are separated by security operations, security posture, and authorization and settings. I'll select Security Operations and apply read-only permissions if I want users to only read the data connected to security operations, or all read and manage permissions if I want users to have the option to manage the incidents and isolate devices, and so on. You can read and manage all permissions connected to security operations. I can also get a bit more granular by selecting custom permissions, where we can say, I want to be able to read the security data. I want to be able to manage alerts and do the response. But I don't want to allow for Tier 1 to do basic live response, advanced live response, or anything that's connected to file collection or managing emails. I also want to give them the security copilot read role, but not permissions for raw email data under email and collaboration. When I'm happy with the permissions assigned, I select Apply and go select Security Posture, which covers permissions for Microsoft Defender Vulnerability Management and Microsoft Security Exposure Management. For Vulnerability and Exposure Management, I want my Tier 1 analysts to be able to read vulnerability management data, but not manage it. The same for Exposure Management. I want analysts to read the data, but not manage it. I select Apply. From Authorization and Settings, for Tier 1, I don't really want to give anything, but I'll cover this segment in the next example. I select Next, Add Assignment. And here, you can add the name SOC Tier 1. Now I need to assign users or groups. Microsoft recommends assignment to a group because it's easier to manage than individual user assignment. In this case, I will choose a user, then choose which data sources I want to scope the specific permission to. This analyst needs to access only Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, so I'll select Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. But if the analyst needs visibility across Defender XDR, I can select All. Next, I review and finish, and I'll submit this specific role configuration, and the new roles will be created. Note that for any Unified RBAC role, you don't need any Global Entra ID role to access the Microsoft Defender XDR portal or manage anything in the Defender XDR portal. If you have a Global Entra ID role, such as Security Operator or Security Administrator, those roles will be on a higher permission level than Unified RBAC roles. You can also create a custom role for authorization, which means a role for somebody who will be creating the permissions. So, select Next, under Authorization and Settings. I'll say this person can read and manage all the authorizations and permissions, and that these people will be able to create any new Unified RBAC permissions. I can remove any of the global roles, like Global Administrator or Security Administrator, that I need to perform these actions without the specific Unified RBAC role. I'll select Next, and then Create Assignment. I'll name it Permission Management and select to whom we want to assign these permissions. I include all the workloads, select Add, select Next, and select Submit. In this case, this user doesn't need global admin or security admin roles to manage unified RBAC permissions anymore. When it comes to Microsoft Sentinel, the permissions are still managed from the Azure portal. From the Azure portal, you can manage permissions either at the subscription level, at the resource group level, or on the resource itself. Based on what I need, I'll be managing the permissions and assigning permissions to users. For example, if you want to manage permissions at the resource group level, go to the resource group and under Access Control, select Add, and then Add Role Assignment. And from here, you can add the new role assignments. If you search for Sentinel, you'll be able to see a couple of Microsoft Sentinel permissions. For example, Microsoft Sentinel Reader, which you assign to anybody who needs to have read access to Microsoft Sentinel data. This means this person will not be able to manage anything on Microsoft Sentinel, in the Microsoft Sentinel Azure portal, or in the Unified SecOps platform. Microsoft Sentinel Responder grants permissions to manage incidents, create automation rules, and more. Microsoft Sentinel Playbook Operator gives you the option to run playbooks on the incidents, and in normal cases, we pair Microsoft Sentinel Playbook Operator with Microsoft Sentinel Responder roles. You also have Microsoft Sentinel Contributor, which is the highest role for Microsoft Sentinel, and gives you access and options when you are working with Microsoft Sentinel. You can assign other roles depending on the users. For example, Logic App Contributor enables users to create logic apps, which are playbooks, in Microsoft Sentinel. You can also assign Log Analytics Contributor and Reader roles based on whether a user needs access to only logs. Instead of granting Microsoft Sentinel permissions, you can assign a user the Log Analytics Reader role, and this user will only be able to access the logs and nothing else in Microsoft Sentinel. Or you can assign the Log Analytics Contributor role, which will give a user a few more options and is more for architects in your organization. All these permissions that we are configuring in the Microsoft Azure portal for Microsoft Sentinel will be respected in the unified platform, but you must still manage Microsoft Sentinel permissions in the Azure portal.